Yo, what is going on, guys? It's your boy Sports Fanatics here, your main man, and today's a special day because we've got your preseason top 25 for season 2 of College Hoops 2K19, your first glimpse of what it's going to be like and what everything is looking like right now. So, obviously, to start off, this is kind of like a new format that we're going with. We've got the rankings on one side, you've got our logo, which you're going to start seeing a lot. On the other side, NCAA 2K19 again, and the Way Too Early Top 25, the AP poll. But yeah, let's get it. So we'll just go from 25 down to 1. Obviously, it's Cincinnati because they won the championship, so we have to put them at 1. But if they didn't, they would have probably been around like 5, and everybody in the top 5 would have moved up one spot. So, a couple things you guys are probably wondering about is how is Texas Tech so high? Probably also wondering about how Kentucky is so low, and we'll get to that. But to start off, we got Villanova. Obviously, this is only a 30-team simulation, so Villanova is one of the worst teams in it, and they proved that last year. So, yeah, if you haven't seen them play and you haven't seen Texas Tech play before, you have an opportunity to see them play. If you've only watched our video of the tournament, we have uploaded a Texas Tech versus Villanova game. It was at Villanova, and Texas Tech was able to pretty much dominate that game. But yeah, so Villanova not very good in this simulation. But yeah, so that's the number 25. For 24, we got Auburn. Auburn's actually a good team, but last year they just didn't do too well. In the first year of the simulation, they were able to win the championship as an 8 seed. They beat Kansas, who was a 1 seed, who that year was actually a really good team. Beat a lot of good teams like Duke that season. So Auburn actually could be like a top 15 team this year. But since they were so bad last year, only like 8 wins in the entire season, they're down at 24. 23 is Ohio State. Another team could be in the top 15. Could make the tournament. Could go pretty far in the tournament because they got some good players. Caleb Wesson, Andre Wesson, Luther Muhammad, CJ Jackson, Keyshawn Woods. They're a pretty good team, but they're down at 23 again because of last season. 22 is TCU. Last year, they made the tournament, but I don't think that's going to happen again this season, as got some good players, got Holloway and Allen Chase. I think that team has a lot of talent, but number 22 spot's not terrible. It's not good either, but yeah, that's pretty much all I gotta say. They're a mediocre team, kind of middle of the pack. Same thing with Virginia. They play good defense like they do in real life. In real life, they play really good defense, but here they play like the best defense in the nation. Their offense is not that good though. Got Kyle Guy, Ty Jerome, DeAndre Hunter, and that's about it on the offensive end. So I don't see him being that great this year. I don't see him making the tournament again, as they got their butts whooped, as you guys saw in the tournament. Number 20, Wichita State. Got some really good players on that team. Greg Tinner, Marcus McDuffie, but that's about it. They also got a couple other guys that are good, like that guy Haynes Jones. I don't know if I've uploaded a Wichita State game before, but they were ranked like in my top 10 to start the season, and they didn't prove anything. Number 19, LSU. I think this LSU team could be a tournament team. In one of the last games of the regular season, their last home game, they played Cincinnati, and they barely lost that game. So I think this year they have a chance. But they're at number 19 because, again, of how they did last year. And obviously, we pretty much don't have any really news about who is going to be going to different teams through the NBA draft or the college hoops draft or recruiting for the incoming freshmen. We don't really know anything about that yet. If they can land somebody, then, yeah, they could be in pretty good shape. But looking ahead, at number 18, Michigan State. I think Michigan State actually this year will be really good. I think they'll make the tournament as like a 3 seed this year and surprise everybody. But right now I have them at number 18 because they're not that talented of a team in terms of the overall to the players that they have. But, yeah, I could see them making a run, possibly winning the championship. As actually the year that they played Auburn, Michigan State was like the 4 seed and Auburn was the 8 seed and Auburn was able to win that championship game. Michigan State made it all the way. I think that could happen again this year. 17, UCLA. UCLA, a couple seasons ago, again, were really good in the second year of the simulation. Got like the 1 seed. They were really good. I don't see them doing that again this year. Or as you saw them last year, not even make the tournament. But they have a chance, like everybody pretty much does, except for teams like Villanova, Miami, Virginia Tech, teams like that. So next up, Xavier. Xavier could also be a top 10 team. They got some talent. Najee Marshall, Paul Scruggs, Quentin Gooden. That team is good. And they've beaten some quality teams last season. And I didn't see them doing it again this season. So, Xavier, watch out for them in the tournament. I think they'll make it this year. I think they'll make it far. Next up, UCF. Obviously, again, winners of the biggest upset in the simulation's history against Duke. What a crazy upset that was. But number 15, sounds a bit right for them. I think they'll be right in that 6-7-8 range again. I think they'll make it. But we're going to be doing some conference realignment to kind of strengthen up each conference, weaken the conference with Duke, Tennessee. And yeah, so we'll be doing some realignment stuff, make a video about that to make each conference about equal and have some really good competition. So next up, North Carolina. Talented team, Luke May, Kobe White, Cam Johnson. But for some reason here, they're just never that great. I'm going to be buffing up a couple of their players, like Cam Johnson and Luke May. But for some reason, they're just not that great. Kentucky, the Wildcats, somewhat low, I think. But really, they're not too low because obviously they did beat Tennessee. They got momentum. But if they hadn't beaten Tennessee, you guys would have been fine with them being at number 13. You guys probably want them at like top 10 or something like that. I don't see that happening though. Number 12 is Nevada. Nevada, really good team. Played really well at the end of the season. Got themselves into the tournament, and not just in the tournament. Got themselves up to a 4 seed in the tournament. So see them getting some momentum. And 12 is actually not bad here. And especially if there is no realignment, which there will be, this Nevada team next year could be like a 2 seed or 1 seed. Number 11 is Michigan. Not very good on offense. Good defensive team. Obviously, you got Jordan Poole, Xavier Simpson, and Brad Stakis. They can score on the offensive end. Other players can also score too, but they're not that great. I see them going right in this 11 range. I think this is about perfect for them. 10, Mississippi State. They got hammered by Gonzaga at home in the tournament, and I think that will transfer in the next season. And I think that they'll be like a 5 or 6 seed in the tournament. But they're going to have some of those other teams. Like, I think Tennessee will be moving over, and there'll be another playoff or tournament team that also moves over. So, yeah, so 9, Syracuse. I think they also have a chance to win the tournament next year. They got George Humphreys in there, who's really good. And, yeah, watch out for them. Extremely talented team on the offensive end. Not as much on the defensive end. But, yeah, that team, gonna probably be talking about them a lot during the regular season. Number 8 is Oregon. This is an Oregon team that just made it to the Final Four and is really good in the tournament. Usually makes a lot of runs. Like, they've done 2 straight Final Fours for the Ducks of Oregon. 2 years ago, 1 seed, losing to Gonzaga at home. Last year, what were they? 5 seed, losing to Gonzaga at home again. 2 straight years in a row. I see them actually probably, if they can make the Final Four, I think that they'll win the championship. And on the number 7 spot, the Houston Cougars. Nothing much to say about them. We've talked about them a lot. Corey Davis and Armani Brooks. We're doing some of the same things that they usually do, along with their really good bench. Play good defense, play really physical though, commit a lot of fouls, but have 3-point shooters. that team could be good again this season. And I see them going about the three or four seed in the conference. Next up, Marquette, number 6. Seems also about right. Marcus Howard. This Marquette team started off 1-6, ended up as a 2 seed in their side of the bracket. Very good team. Marcus Howard won the Wooden Award or the MVP or the top player award, whatever you want to call it, in the simulation last year. Don't be surprised if he wins it again this year. Number 5, Texas Tech. This Texas Tech team could actually win that side. Could be the 1 seed in that side with Cincinnati and stuff. That's a team that really, if you looked at that side, not very good. But you add Texas Tech to that team, to that side, along with like Tennessee and maybe Syracuse, you've got a really good side over there. Next up, you've got, keeping on going with Texas Tech, they've got Jakovin Dixon, great player for a clutch, along with Yante Jordan, and the point guard who's also really good. And don't forget about Jarrett Culver. That guy's a beast as well. So, also Dwayne Pollard, 7'6". Dang. And some of these players actually aren't real in real life. You've probably never heard of them before. They're just user-created players. So, yeah. And moving on, number 4, Gonzaga. This Gonzaga team is actually really good. They've got some really good players on their team. Obviously making the national championship this year. For the second straight year, 2 years ago, they won it. Or last year, they won it. This year, lost to Cincinnati. Yeah, so Tennessee, again, Williams, Schofield, Bone. Don't be surprised if that group of players is able to win a lot of games again. Probably be transferring conferences as well to the other side of the bracket. Next up, Duke, the Blue Devils. Zion, RJ, Trey Jones, Cam Reddish, Marquise Bolden. That team, I think, is one of the favorites, along with Texas Tech, Marquette, and Syracuse, I would say, to win the championship this year. And so if Cincinnati hadn't won, they would definitely have been number 1. But next up, you've got Cincinnati, like we said, and we've talked about. I don't think they're that good, don't have that good of an offense, but they won the championship, so obviously they got to be number 1 coming into next season. They won't get that great of a player from the draft or that great of a recruit. But next year, I think that they will make the tournament and they'll be a top 4 seed. I don't see them getting the 1 seed again. So yeah, that rounds up the way too early top 25, and see ya.